of today is to talk a little bit about the power of using newspapers, but using newspapers in a slightly different way. So when we first started talking about this, I belong to the Keypoint Intelligence team. And when we started talking about all the things that we had on offer, I ended up being part of the program for every day. So this is the Keypoint Intelligence commercial, because it's because of them I'm allowed to be here. And so we are sort of an international group of both market researchers and product testers. And hopefully if you need services like ours, you will come and talk to us. And there's a nice group sitting here in the back who will be delighted to sell you something. We do all of this stuff, and they'd be delighted to sell you something along these lines. The really important thing to know is it's a really smart group of people, and we cover all sorts of print stuff, office print stuff, production print stuff, software involved in it, and we're a lot of fun. Commercial over. So let's go on to why we're here. So I think we all know that circulations among newspapers around the world kind of declining as a rule. Generalist magazines struggling as well. Loyalty magazines tending to do okay. Magazines and newspapers in general, they're not really dinosaurs. They just need a little bit of repurposing as a rule. And the really interesting thing that started to happen over the last 4 or 5 years with the rise of cost-effective digital printing and finishing and distribution solutions is that we've started to see the emergence of new uses for magazine formats and for newspaper formats. And that's what I want to share with you today. I knew there was a clicker here somewhere if I just looked around long enough. So what do we know about newspapers? You know, we know that as a rule, the volumes are declining, and in a lot of ways, they're perceived as being too costly to print for a lot of reasons, and that nobody needs them, but, you know, that really might be fake news. Because, in fact, they aren't dead, they've just changed. What's happened is that smart printers around the world, but most specifically in Europe, which is where we've seen it really take hold, is they've learned to sort of assuage some of the pain and turn it into an opportunity. European citizens, and I'll include the UK in that, European citizens read newspapers, sort of read them at a pretty good clip. Three-quarters of Swiss citizens are reading a newspaper every day. It's not, you go to Italy and that number is about the same. If you go up into Northern Europe, it's about the same. Europe tends to be a commuter culture, so the newspapers often follow the fact that you're sitting on a train or on a bus for some period of time. And so there's a sort of a captured audience. But the most read newspapers, when we started to take a look at it, were actually specialty newspapers of different kinds. Sometimes they're expat newspapers. Sometimes they're, you know, I'm living in a different country than the one I was born in, but I want to know more about what's going on at home. So I spend a little bit more money and I subscribe to the paper version. And very often it is the paper version and not the digital version, because people like that tangible feel. So we've seen a lot of interesting newspaper organizations figure out how to do licensing of content so that they can create American newspapers in Europe, European newspapers in the US. You go to Australia, you can find everything, and it's all printed digitally. And it's a pretty interesting business model. Here's some proof of how it works. So the folks at CSQ in Italy, whoops, I didn't do that. The folks at CSQ in Italy are a sort of a forward-thinking group of people. It's a consortium that got together. They own the big WYFAG newspaper presses, and they print the northern Italian newspapers. And they have a pretty good business, but they also saw that, you know, the volumes were declining. They were struggling a little bit more with advertising, so they started to think about What could they do with what they know how to do? They know how to produce and finish newspapers. So they took the step of first looking out around. It has a mind of its own, and I don't know why. So they took a look at what they were doing and the kinds of newspapers that they were producing, and they reached out in different directions to find organizations that might be interested in printing in Italy instead of flying newspapers in from Russia or Scandinavia or Asia. And they ended up forming some interesting partnerships, both with some Russian papers, with the Financial Times, and with the Telegraph, because there were a lot of people vacationing in Italy during the summer, and they set up summer availability of the paper by printing them locally instead of flying them in. So why does that matter? Because one, it's expensive to fly newspapers, right? They're heavy, you have to pallet them, they're hard to manage. So they not only, they found a way to work with the distributors and actually partnered with the distributors to say, okay, instead of flying those newspapers in, we'll license those newspapers, we'll print them here locally, and we'll deliver them in the same normal distribution channel that you already have partnered with us for. It actually worked, and typically in the summers, if you're in Italy, you can buy newspapers from all over Europe that are actually printed in Italy, even though they are from all over the world. The next step, they're not there yet, but they're getting there. Their next step is to actually put the local advertising in to the foreign newspaper, because a PDF file is sent to CSQ for printing. CSQ, very smart people, they know how to go in and cut an ad out and put another ad in, so that's the next step. There's still some licensing issues to go through, right? There's legal stuff with everything, but that will be totally groundbreaking when they get that done. And it's just a really interesting way to change the way foreign newspapers are sold in any given location. Once they figured out how to do that, and these newspapers are printed digitally, they're printed on digital devices, not on the inkjet devices, not on their big Wi-Fi. So, well, they're not printing enough newspapers to keep those inkjet presses busy. And inkjet presses are really hungry. They want to print all the time. They don't like to sit still. So, okay, what else can we do that looks like a newspaper? What can we create? So they ended up creating, the first one was called Eventi. Eventi is an event newspaper format. And what it's meant to do is to create both a lead up to a big event and become the daily event newspaper for different kinds of events. It can be a sports championship. It can be a parish festival. It can be a citywide festival. This was being done before they were sort of leading up to the Milan Expo a couple years ago. So with Eventi, it's the same idea. The newspaper team at CSQ works with the local advertisers and the event organizers, but it's printed as a newspaper and it's delivered as a newspaper. And because CSQ has the relationship with the distribution channel, it can be an insert into the daily newspapers that are already printed, or it can be standalone, a free paper, left in shopping malls and restaurants and all sorts of other places that you might want to have people pick it up. But when the event rolls around, it can actually become the daily newspaper of the event as well, and they can update all the stories and sell net new advertising. So it's a whole new way of looking at using the newspaper format. The interesting thing is that for CSQ, it sort of took on a life of its own, and it's become a business all by itself. They now also produce Il Cittadino, which is a very local, hyper-local city newspaper that gets inserted into the big offset printed version. They do special editions. They do special events. This one was for one of the dance events, festivals that they were doing. They've done them for specific fashion shows. They've done them for all sorts of little, every little town has a church. Every church has a church newsletter. Those church newsletters are expensive to produce for the church as a rule. So in many of the parishes, they've now partnered with the different churches to bring all the stuff that used to be in the church bulletin. It's now part of small pullout sections that are printed and delivered with the newspaper specifically for the people in that parish. So digitally printed inserts into the regular newspaper. And the way it's financed is that CSQ sells the advertising and they own the advertising and the church gets it effectively for free because they'll also deliver those inserts to the church for delivery to their constituents. So that's just one way of looking at newspapers being a little bit different. But it's not the only way that newspapers can be different. I have a very good friend because of years of working with them. They were my customer called Semeta. And I love these guys, they're in Belgium, and they are the in-house print company associated with the grocery chain called Colruyt. Semeta was originally an offset print producer. Over time, they started to see the value of going digital, but you know, it's a company-owned print shop, they had to walk carefully. So as they began to walk through carefully, they started to have some wild and crazy ideas about things that you couldn't do. And one of the wild and crazy ideas that they had came out of a problem that was presented to them. One of the other companies that Colruyt owns is a company called Zeb. Zeb makes jeans. They are a fashion retailer. So it's the kind of store that you might find in a shopping mall or in a shopping center where you walk in and they have all the different fashion brands. They have the Levi's and the Lee's and all the different stuff. The stores were not performing particularly well, so they tried some postcard direct mail campaigns. And the stores were still not performing well. And they were on the precipice. Do we shut the stores down because they're not performing, or do we try one more marketing thing? So the one more marketing thing that they tried was the direct mail newspaper. And the interesting thing is, it worked. If you were a member of the loyalty program for Zeb, you received the first newspaper in 2012. So this isn't very, very recent. The very first one was released in 2012. It was Drupa, for me it was a Drupa thing for 2012. It's personalized. The names that you see here are actually employees of Semeta, whose names have been added in to take the real customer name out because it's the EU and we don't want to get in trouble. But every person who received the newspaper, they were either the stud of the year or the model of the year with their name. But it didn't stop there. Everything about the newspaper was personalized. Every edition of it was completely unique. The advertisements changed depending on what your buying patterns were. So if Roberta here, sitting in the front, only ever bought Levi's, but maybe once she bought a pair of Lee's or Wranglers, they would look at that data. And if Roberta only ever bought girl clothes, she never bought one pair of men's shirt, jeans, whatever, all of her, all of the stories in the newspaper and all of the advertisements will be targeted to a female who buys more or less the same size clothes. But if you ever bought one pair of jeans for your husband, your boyfriend, whatever, they would sprinkle a few other ads in it, a few other stories in it. And if it looked like you bought clothes of a lot of different sizes, they would not assume that you were me and going up and down in size all the time. What they would assume is that you were a family buyer. And so they would change again the nature of the stories that were included and the nature of the offers that were included. And this is printed in one newsprint, and you will note they were fearless. Remember the brand stories you may have heard in this theater all day today. Brand people are very, very picky. So Zeb took a huge risk because they had to convince all of these retailers that it was okay to print their stuff on newsprint using an inkjet printer, a high-speed inkjet printer. That was not a trivial sale. But the Zeb marketing team working with their print provider, Semeta, they were able to make that sale to these people, to Flair and to Diesel and to Only and to Mongo and all the other big brands that are carried in a Zeb store. And they convinced them to let them do version one of the newspaper. The agreement was for one. The newspaper went out the door with all of the variations. Funny thing happened. When the newspaper went into the mail, in an envelope, it had to because it had the names on it, right? The stores saw an uptick. Within 48 hours, they had to add staff into the stores. They had to call staff in because people were not only coming into the store, they were bringing the newspapers with them and going, I want this. My girlfriend, she didn't get the newspaper with her name on it. Why didn't she get that? Oh, she does not appear to be in the loyalty database. Would she like to join the loyalty program? Oh, she does? Great, so sign her up. Okay, she'll get the next newspaper. There was only a small problem there. There hadn't actually been a plan for a second newspaper. So there was a second newspaper. And a third and a fourth, because this got to be the thing that loyal customers, they expected now to get their personalized newspaper. And the results were really pretty dramatic. For Semeta, they did a number of things here that were pretty groundbreaking. And remember, this started in 2012. This is 2017, so we got a history here we can look at. But they got everybody from Jack Jones, from Madonna, from Hilfiger, Street One, all of these guys to play along with them to print their brand colors, their pieces, on newsprint using a high-speed inkjet press, which everyone told us couldn't be done. Nobody would accept it, no brand would accept it. But if you've got the right value proposition, newspapers can be sexy. And a funny thing happened, those millennials Deborah was talking about, those generationally challenged, I would call them, but okay. those people who are younger than me, because as Deborah pointed out, I lied when I raised my hand. They thought newspapers were cool. Getting a newspaper with their name on it was really pretty cool. And the fact that it had offers that were specifically for them, honestly, probably didn't register until they got to the store and realized that the person standing next to them had different offers. And it really didn't matter till they only cared about what was in their newspaper. So for Semeta, 30% more promotions, stop that, were used. Doubled the number of fans and conversion on Facebook, because this had a Facebook campaign associated with it as well. If you took a picture of yourself with your newspaper and you posted it to Facebook, you got another special offer. And if you go out, even now, if you go out to the Zeb Facebook page and you dial it back to 2012, you can see that first wave of people going, my God, I got a newspaper with my name on it. And look, it's got my clothes in it. Isn't that really cool? And it really did improve the relationship between Zeb and their customers. It's that relationship that Deborah was talking about that got built really tightly. But the really neat part of it is that the unintended consequence, which later became an intended consequence, is it improved the data that Zeb had about their customers, which they were then able to leverage into additional marketing campaigns. So for today, there's something funny that's happening here. I press it once, it goes twice. It's probably my PowerPoint, it's not you guys. They really changed the way they're marketing. Zeb became the incubator for the Semeta team to try a bunch of things out. And it allowed them to learn a lot about how to use different media, newsprint specifically, to change the marketing talk track among their clients. Zeb was so successful. If you come back tomorrow, I'll tell you what the next stage was. But beyond Zeb, yeah, teasing is my life. But beyond Zeb, they took this concept of using a newspaper as a marketing tool, and they turned it into a whole lot of other things. So they turned it into the Vanderkamp newspaper, which was a personalized holiday newspaper. If you had been doing business with this travel agency, you now got a newspaper instead of, you know, the flat postcard or the envelope or the catalog with the 800 trips that you might be able to take. Now you got a personalized newspaper targeted to the kind of travel that you normally do. And this changed so much about the relationship between the agency and their clients. It is unusual to see a travel company run out of space in their available holiday their vacation bookings, but these guys were doing it. When what was happening is it shortened the amount of time between the drop of the marketing piece and the time that all of the vacations available were totally booked out. It had been going for 3 months, and now it was down to 4 weeks with the newspaper. The other thing that they did was a little weird. This, by the way, is an award winner. You know, in advertising and marketing, we love to give ourselves awards. And this one has been awarded both in the US and in Europe. It has won awards. So the last one I'll share with you is this one called Kazoo. The weirdest story. Kazoo got the idea of using newspapers to market. Kazoo is holiday camps for kids. So they've been using an offset style newspaper that Semeta had been doing for them for a number of years. So Semeta said, well, you know, we could personalize it out to everybody, you know, all the parents of all the kids who are sending their kids to holiday camp. Kazoo said, we don't know. We don't know about this digital stuff. Oh, and you want to print it on an inkjet press? We don't know about that. So they said, well, let us try something for you. How about we keep the middle printed on a litho machine, just like we've been doing for years, but we'll do the wrap. We'll do page 1, 2, and the last two pages. We'll do that digital. We'll personalize it a little bit. You've got some data. You know how many kids the family has, because you've been selling them camp slots. You know the ages of the kids, because you've been registering them for camp. You know where they've been, right? So you know which one of the camps they went to. Well, let us try a few things. So they did. So what you're seeing here on the left is a family that has two kids, and each kid gets a color, and now on both the front and the back, the things that are surrounded by that color relate to that kid, the age. This one is 3, You can have up to 9. The killer was that they had 10, 11, and 12 kids in some of the families. They had to get very creative. Those had to be done by hand, but the rest of these were templated, right? It worked. They sold out the camp slots on an average in half the time that they had taken in previous years. They were so successful by the second year that they did it that they had to build more camp slots into their plan. It's the power of a newspaper that isn't a newspaper. It's how you make newspapering great again. So my whole reason for sharing this is that newspapers aren't dead. There's something that every marketer should consider. And if you're a printer, think about how you might participate in the really cool programs and offer these to your clients and help them grow their stories. It's a little bit of forward thinking, it's a little bit of piloting, a bit of design, a bit of marketing, but it's really cool when it works. And keep calm. We're here to help. If you want to know about this story, more about this story, or any of the other stories that you hear me tell, don't hesitate to drop me a note. I have a partner in crime. His name is Ryan McAbee, and between us, we're always happy to help. James is going to figure out how to make these presentations available. If you need a copy of it before we figure that out, just shoot me an email, and I'm more than happy to help out. So that's my publishing story. A little different than Don's, but a little bit fun, too. Thanks a lot.